Hello students, I am Dr. Prakash Salunke from Mechanical Engineering Department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss about fuel systems in SI engines. So this will be the second part from the IC engine series. The outcome expected is students will be able to explain the requirements of air fuel mixture at different operating conditions of IC engine. What are the mixture requirements for the combustion? There are two essential requirements for the mixture supplying device or carburetor. One is that it should meter the liquid fuel in proper quantity to produce the required air fuel ratio at different load and speed conditions. And second requirement is that it should be able to produce the homogeneous mixture of air and fuel which is possible by atomizing the fuel. Now, what are different conditions of engine operation? Let us try to understand. There are mainly two categories of engine running condition. One is steady state and another is transient, for which the requirements of the mixture, they are different, I mean air fuel mixture. Steady state refers to continuous operation at a particular speed and power output with normal engine temperature. And the transient state refers to changing or dynamic conditions where either one or more parameters such as speed, load of the engine are changing. Now let us see more about steady state condition. Steady state occurs under three circumstances. One is idling and low loads. Second is normal power range. And third is high or maximum power range. One by one, let us study. During idling and low loads, so that is 20% of the power. So engine is running with no load, it means idling. In both of these conditions, lesser throttle opening will be there, throttle opening, and it causes low suction pressure, which results in backflow of exhaust gases and air leaks from other parts. So this leads to poor thermal efficiency and higher exhaust emissions. To overcome this, say there is need of rich mixture, say that is required, say in this particular condition. So air fuel ratio should be around 12.5:1. So that is the requirement. So if we see this table and graph, we will find, say, there are different conditions. So this is idling and low load 0 to 20 of the, rated power. And here the problem is dilution of mixture due to products of combustion. So the air fuel ratio should be richer 12.5:1. And say this is, written here. So if we see graphically, so this is the state. So where there is a requirement 0 to 20, load is smaller, and say richer air fuel ratio, so they are required. The second condition is normal power, where we produce 20% to 75% of the rated load. And naturally, this is the major operation area. The requirement should be of the economy. Economy should be the main consideration, and for achieving economy, air fuel ratio are required to be leaner, say 16.5:1 or 17:1 practically, up to 75% of the load. Beyond that, so it is a range of maximum power. In maximum power, say again, say there is a richer fuel air mixture. Fuel air mixture should be there. So air fuel ratio should be more, higher. So they are around 14:1, like that. So here that for normal power, it is also called as cruising range. Air fuel ratio requirement should be 17:1. And maximum power range So it is in the range of 14 to 1 rich mixture. Now what happens in case of multi-cylinder engines, mixture from the carburetor is supplied through intake manifold and there are inlets to each of the cylinder. So there are chances of variation in air fuel ratio throughout different cylinders or between the cylinders, because outer cylinders will be getting richer mixtures. Why? The liquid droplets which are carried, because of their inertia, they will not turn immediately in the earlier cylinders and they will be carried out, say, in subsequent cylinders. So outer cylinders, they get relatively richer mixtures. Now, transient mixture. So these are the steady state conditions. The main transient conditions of operations are starting and warm up, acceleration and deceleration. Requirements in transient state are different than those of steady state because the evaporation of fuel may not be complete. Petrol is a mixture of hydrocarbons and these are having different boiling temperatures. Those having high vapor pressure and low boiling point are called as light ends, while those which are opposite to it means lower vapor pressure and higher boiling point. So they are called heavy ends. In different transient conditions, let us see how this affects. The first is starting and warm up requirements. While starting from cold, speed and temperatures both are low, especially in cold weather or early in the morning. Hence, much of the heavy ends do not vaporize. They remain in the liquid form. Therefore, ratio of evaporated fuel to air will be too lean to ignite. Hence, much richer mixtures, air-fuel ratio of 3:1 or sometimes 1.5:1 are to be supplied so that enough light ends in the vaporized form are available for combustion. Too high volatility leads to formation of vapor bubble in the carburetor and disturbs the metering of the fluid. While too low volatility causes condensation of fuel on cylinder walls, leading to carbon deposits and dilution of engine oil, so that reduces the lubrication power. Then there is the acceleration requirement. For accelerating, that is to increase the engine speed, throttle is open fully. As a result, fuel evaporated in the intake manifold moves at much faster speed, and fuel in the liquid form, so that forms a film on the walls of the induction system. So that is not carried out. What happens? The liquid lags behind temporarily and cylinder receives a leaner mixture rather than rich mixture requirement. Therefore, to supply additional fuel to make the mixture rich, a separate arrangement is needed and is normally provided in the form of acceleration pump. Now, figure 2 shows the construction of simple or basic carburetor design, which is normally useful to fulfill the requirements of normal power running or in a steady state conditions. Let us see this particular figure. So this is a figure of simple carburetor. As you can see here, so this is the air inlet. This is the choke valve. We shall study it later. And here, so this is the, say, reduction in area venturi is formed. And say this is the throttle valve, so with which we can control the quantity. So this is the fuel supply chamber. Here there is a float. From here, say there are tubes or pipelines, small pipelines, so which lead, say here, the fuel in the the supply manifold. This is air vent, this is strainer, and this is the fuel incoming from the tank. Now, fuel, as the air comes inside, say fuel will be supplied from the tank, and when the pressure is low, so due to suction, I mean, or the vacuum created, say the fuel will be sucked here, say through this jet. So by opening the throttle, we can control the speed as well as the quantity of air fuel mixture inside, and say accordingly, say we shall be getting the required. Now this is the preliminary design of the carburetor. The detailed working and modifications required will be continued in our next session. So the discussion on that, because it's not possible to cover in this particular session. Now for this particular session, I have taken the references from Book of IC Engine by Mathur and Sharma. Similarly, this is the website from which I have taken certain figures. So I thank to them and thank to you also.